Yo, Crypto Up Dad, welcome to another video. Thank you for sticking with us. If you're new, please just hit the like and subscribe button to support what we're doing. We bring you crypto updates and tech hikes and all of that. Thank you so very much. Let's get started. We're learning how to, you know, manage our data consumption if you're a Windows user. Yeah, Windows user, we suffer a lot, trust me. You know, the Linux users, they don't really experience all of this kind of thing, but we, the Windows, trust me, I can't be connected to the internet and I don't even know what's taking my bandwidth. That's sad and that's messed up. So that's what we're trying to fix today. You're gonna see magic in reality, bro. Trust me. So let's get started. First off, I'm connected to my Wi-Fi. So free things don't last. Yeah, that's facts. So first fix we're gonna be looking at, we're gonna click on properties. That's the first fix for today. This is the conventional fix. Everybody should know this, yeah? So you go to metered connection and then you make sure this is turned on. If it was off, you just click on it and it's on. That's simple. So that's the first fix, and it doesn't really work the magic. Your data must still be consumed by unknown forces, let's put it that way. So next fix is, we're gonna go to services, just search there, and there's some services, a bunch of services. We're gonna stop the services. They are the services that, you know, you trigger this high data consumption. You just know you're browsing, it's going very smooth. Before you know, you're just that seeing that, trust me, your data is gone. What is this fix? The first fix is background intelligence transfer service. All right, see, the name is so long. So that's the first one. Double click on it. Now we're gonna stop it. All right, it's already stopped. Whoa, it stopped. Okay, let's just do it again for the sake of this video. All right, so we stop it. Whoa, it's not stopping. Okay, it stopped. Stop, you can see status, it's no longer running. So, and then the next thing you gotta do is you make sure it's set to manual, because when you say, oh, you can actually set it to disabled. Yeah, click on OK. The next one is delivery optimization. Yeah, that's it. Just double click on it, click on stop. This one here, you can't actually change it to, it has to be automatic. It's really an important service in Windows, because not all system I want to stop it. If I try mine and I hit OK, it's gonna deny me access, so I just prefer to leave it at that. Yeah, so you see the status is no longer running. So what that means is that for this particular one, you have to, you know, come to stop it anytime you restart your PC, because it's gonna restart itself. That's why it's automatic, whilst the other one we stopped, the background intelligence, it was disabled, so it might not trigger off itself again. And that's it. So lastly, Windows update. Yeah, that's the big fish, Windows update. So this right here, you can see the status is running. Yeah, just double click on it, do same thing, stop it, and then click on disabled. All right, hit okay. So that's it, we've stopped some services, right? And this also is disabled. So let's say you actually want to do your Windows update yourself, don't remember to come and, you know, enable this back and start it up. Okay, so there's some softwares too. The next fix, we'll move on to the next fix. All right, well, my hard drive is not plugged. All right, just did the okay. So just some softwares, two important softwares we will need in this video. Okay, this right here, Dumeter, I think, just Dumeter and the glass wire, they say it. So I'm gonna leave this in the description of this video so you can download them. Shout out to Get Into PC, the ones that provide us with a bunch of softwares. We get them for free, literally. Softwares, paid softwares, got them for free. So much appreciate them. They've been really helpful in the space. Alright, so the first one we're installing is DU-Meter. So let's install it. These are two softwares that are really gonna blow your mind. They're doing the real magic here, right? So we hit next, we do the regular stuff, all that. Okay. And then remember it's a paid software, we're gonna be cracking it, right? Okay. So let's just chill out, Wait for it to install. Alright, make sure you don't launch it, finish, you know, all that cracking hacks and the rest of that. Just make sure you apply them right now. So even your antivirus, make sure it's disabled. If you don't know how to do that, you just press the Windows key and I to go to the main place. You click on update and security, then you can come to Windows security. Info, come here, and then you can see, make sure it's up, right? Okay, so now we can load up our patch. Just open it, it might prompt you something, just give it access, grant it access, and all right, okay, gotta crack it. Yeah, patching done. So we can quit, close that. And next software, let's just install the softwares all at once so that I'll just, you know, wrap it up there. Glasswire, we're gonna do the same thing. Yep. Alright. Okay. Accept terms and conditions. You know, some people expect you to read all of that stuff. Well, if you read it, you love reading, man. I never think I read that stuff before. I never did, trust me. Okay, it's registering. Let's also go and have a look at the patch. Now we can just open it and wait for it. Alright, waiting. Okay, so we're not gonna run it. Finish. Now our patch is open, just select Pro and you patch it. It's gonna do some little magic. Yeah. Okay, we're waiting for that too. Just close every other thing that we don't need. Okay, I see they're creating some. Okay, yeah, patch done. Yes, we wanna open the program. Go ahead, man. All right, just gonna delete this little bins here. I don't like my desktop messed up. Okay. Yep, we have the glass wire. Let's start with the DU-Meter. I'm just gonna give you a quick rundown on how it works. The DU-Meter, firstly, it shows you what is taking your data. All right, let's close this. I don't want it to be giving us some prompts so that I don't get to explain a lot of stuff. All right. Okay, finish. Then you hit on next, so it's gonna bring up this little guy here. Now what the DU-Meter does, it gives you statistics. So it gives you like your data counter in real time, trust me, in real time. So even browsing, you see today's record, you can see it right there, is it's gonna be increasing the moment I begin to browse, right? The moment I begin to surf the internet, it's gonna start increasing. So it gives you your count. And then it actually, through this graph here, or you're gonna change this to programs, and then just expand it a little bit. We don't need cents, we can see total. Total is gonna be okay, yeah, the total. Okay, so you see, the moment I begin to browse, it's gonna show me the stuffs that are taking my bandwidth at the moment. Okay, so let's see. So if, Let's open something up. Okay, let's open my upper. You see that? Right, just search something. Okay, you can see it's beginning to count, right? You see it's increasing. Can you see? Can you see? Can you see? Yeah. So that's what DUmeter is for. Really profound software. If you want to reset it, you can actually do that. You just right click on this, go to administrator options, and just wait for it to open. You can see now this right here is showing us the stuffs that are, you know, consuming our data, what's taking the data right now. So upper mini, upper auto update, so we're gonna come to that. And that's where the, so if you want to stop any software, that's where the Glasswire comes in. So okay, for resetting your count, you see the count is 4 MB right now. So if you want to reset it, you just right click, right, you come to administrator option, that's what brought this out, then you head on to database management, then you click on delete. It's gonna delete the old history, and then boom, check it out. You see it's reset to zero, so you can start a fresh count if you want to monitor. There are other features, trust me, in this DUmeter. I think you can set a limit and stuff like that, but we're not going to be diving into that because of time. Now back to the Glasswire. Okay, the DUmeter, if you don't see this showing, if it's closed, what you can do is just come to your, there's the icon, the taskbar, just double click on it, it's going to open back. Then the Glasswire, this is its icon right here, you can see it, right? Okay, so click on it, it opens. Now this is really the whole magic, trust me, this is the main magic, not the rest that I've been showing you. So the firewall, the Glasswire has a firewall feature where we can block whatsoever software program or service we don't want to, you know, take our bandwidth. So how we gonna do that, how we gonna do that? So click on firewall, turn it on. That's we here right now. You click on this, and I prefer to change this to X to connect. Yeah, always ask me to connect. So what that means is, if a software or program wants to connect to the internet, wants to interact with the internet, it's gonna bring out a prompt here and ask you for permission. So you're gonna click on allow or deny, right? Okay, let's try one and see. So then any software that accesses the internet begins to show up here, right? Begins to show up here. So now let's say I want to block Opera from accessing the net. What I'll just come to do is this little guy here, I'll just click on there, and I've blocked it. So it's on the blocked. You see, it brings out a fire kind of stuff. So it's burnt, it's blocked. Yeah, then I can see this. I don't really need my Opera to update right now. If I want to do it, I'm gonna do it myself. So just clicking that button too. Now you can see this Glasswire control service. It's not really important. This one here, I don't need it. You know this service, what it does is, if I search something, it can, let's say I search what I can find, it's gonna bring out some search result from the internet. I don't need that, trust me, I don't use it, so I don't need it. So you just click on this, like two. Now you can see what I was talking about right here, you can see it right here, right? So this here, I don't need it, this Microsoft Office, so I'll just click deny. So you see some services are trying to access the net, so you're gonna prompt me first. Let's try to open something else. Let's try to open this, the Brave browser. You know I love the Brave browser, right? Okay, so you see it's bringing out a prompt there, and what you gotta do is deny, and let's see, you will not be able to access the internet. You see, that's the magic. Now if you want to allow it, you go back to your service, to the firewall feature here in Glasswire. So you see blocked softwares will be here. So if you want to unblock it, you just click on that. It's freaking crazy, trust me. So let's browse and you see the magic. Okay, that was Brave, right? That was Brave. You definitely know it's gonna browse, it's gonna browse, trust me. You see I just clicked on Word, it's trying to access the internet, so I'm gonna deny it. I don't need that too. You see, it's working. You see, it's working. You see, typing what we want and we're seeing it. So that's it. With these two features, trust me, you are doing crazy stuff. And mind you, I'ma tell you this, there's certain services that you cannot actually, you know, restrict from the internet. Something like this right here, this is the SVC host. It's a very, very important service when you're connected to the internet. If you stop this, you might not be able to browse. That's right, you will not be able to access the internet. I don't think it's gonna work. It's not gonna work. Yeah, it's very important. You can read about it. The SVC host, that's what connects the whole system to the internet. So this is the name, host process for Windows services. So we'll go ahead and unblock it. Yeah, you can see, I think we might now be able to access the net. Let's try it. Maybe network issues. Yeah, I believe it's network, because once you unblock that, you're supposed to browse. Okay, so that's it. That's it. Generally, with this two basic softwares and the rest of the general fix, you see, that's the SVC host right there. It's really important. So you're going to be seeing it showing up. So when I'm browsing, when I'm connecting to the internet, I'm doing some heavy downloads and stuff, I like to leave this opened. I like to leave this to be X to connect. So if I have a software that wants to access the internet, you don't just do it with your own permission, man. This is my PC. I bought it with my money, my hard-earned money. So, you know, that's just a joke. So if this is really just follow the prompts, and I'll love to answer your questions. You can drop your questions in the comment section. And thank you so very much for watching. Thank you.